The Miami Heat are one of three teams who got swept in the first round after making the finals. The 07 Heat after they won the 06 championship. The 2011 Mavericks after they won the 2011 championship. And well, the 2021 Heat after they made the 2020 finals. But look, man, today we finna go over, was last season a fluke? Was them making the finals a fluke? And what my thoughts on it are. Now look, my past couple videos have aged terribly so far. The one that I said the Clippers are in trouble when they were down 0-2. Well, they just came back two games. They have all the momentum going into Staples Center now. God damn. Then for my playoff predictions, I said the Knicks will win in six. Yeah. And I said the Heat-Bucks series would go to seven. Well, I wish it did, because I would have still some life in me. But I don't. But hey, there's something we can look forward to. If this video ages terribly while I'm talking about the Heat suffering, that means they can only get better, right? Okay, since this 2021 season has been so ugly for the Heat, let's start where it all started, in the offseason. In the offseason, the Heat lost Jay Crowder and instead signed professional cheerleader, anti-Semitic, Myers Leonard to $10 million. Let's fucking go, bruh. Just a great move. We know this is an elite GM in Pat Riley. This is the things he does. Now, real shit, I have trust in Pat Riley. But that wasn't the move, to say the least. They picked up Avery Bradley. He's a solid 3-and-D guard. Well, he didn't play much for them. In fact, he only played 10 games for Miami. And, well, yeah, he was traded soon. But if we just look at the offseason, the Miami's offseason was a negative. They lost Jay Crowder, who was very important to their success, who they traded for. They traded for him and Andre Iguodala to try and get some defensive wing help for Giannis. And Jay Crowder, he hasn't been clamping up LeBron in that Phoenix series. But he's definitely been giving him a couple problems. Now, that's a big loss for the Miami Heat. The Miami Heat's offseason was definitely a negative. There was no fucking positive in it. I just saw it as, hey, look, Bam will get older, hopefully improved. And yes, he did. Tyler Hero was getting older. Hopefully he will improve. Well, we're still calling it hopefully because he's not been improving. Kendrick Nunn, Duncan Robinson, this whole young core, it should have time to improve. And we should maybe not make it back to the finals, but we should still be in somewhat of contention. And we know going throughout the whole season, the biggest problem for the Miami Heat was Jimmy Butler's health. That's why they were out of the playoffs for most of the season until they came back and became the sixth seed within the last 3 weeks of the season. But it was Jimmy Butler's health. This motherfucker was not healthy at all. Is that probably why he was playing terrible in this Bucks series? Was he not completely healthy? I don't know, maybe. But we're not going to put that as an excuse. Jimmy Butler's health was a big downside to this Miami Heat season. Not only that, the Miami Heat did trade for Victor Oladipo, as we all know. And in the end of the day, the trade is not looking too positive. This motherfucker Kelly Olynyk is on a whole different level in Houston. But goddamn, this motherfucker Kelly Olynyk is hooping. We gave up Kelly Olynyk and Avery Bradley for Victor Oladipo, who I think he played 5 games for us. So the injury bug is just all over this Miami Heat team. So yeah, the Heat end as the 6th seed. They were the 7-8 seed for a lot of the time. And yeah, it was a disappointing season up to that point. But what made it even more disappointing was getting swept. Nobody had a thought that Miami was going to get swept. You know, I think a lot of teams could have taken at least one game off the Bucks. Unless the Bucks are going to win the championship this year, I feel like a lot of teams could. And well, Miami is going to be the only team in the first round that is swept this season. That fucking sucks. They were just in the finals last year. Let's talk about if the finals run last season was a fluke. Now, first of all, I'm going to state off by saying it isn't. There's two definitions of a fluke to me. One definition of a fluke is that you can't make it happen again. Well, I think up to this point, unless Miami gets Kawhi, which will that will be a whole different other team, then yeah, I think it's a fluke. They can't do it again right now in the current situation. But I feel like if you meant fluke as in like every single round that they won was by virtue of luck, I don't think that's the truth. I think they won every single round and were the better team in every single round that they won. So let's start into it, man. They played the Bucks in the second round. They upset the first seed. God damn it, Giannis, bro, his whole reputation is terrible. at this point, it's like, man, you win back-to-back MVPs. Now you're a defensive player of the year. And, well, you average 22 points and lose to the Miami Heat, a team who wasn't even expected to get out of the second round. And not only do you let them beat you, they almost swept you. They beat you in five. So would I say beating them in five is kind of a fluke? Yeah. I feel like that Bucks team was too good to just beat in five. The Heat had to have some luck on their way to beat them in five. Can they still beat them? Yes, I still did expect them to beat them. But damn it, five? And then if we look at the Eastern Conference Finals, they went against the Boston Celtics. And I don't think this was a fluke in the slightest. The Boston Celtics blew many double-digit leads. That's what like led to that breakout in the locker room, whatever they said with Marcus Smart, that one game. And yeah, the series did end up going in six. But look, that series was just ugly for the Boston Celtics. I don't think that was a fluke. I think that was more on the Boston Celtics being terrible than the Miami Heat being amazing. And then now we're in the finals. And the Miami Heat get hurt. Goran Dragic, Bam Adebayo, they both go down. But Jimmy Butler has the great, like one of the greatest finals we've seen in a minute. As in just carry jobs alone. And yeah, it was quite beautiful as a Miami Heat fan. But look, do I think it's a fluke? No, I don't. Do I see them replicating that anytime soon? No, unless the team changes drastically and you get Kawhi Leonard in free agency, which is looking less and less likely now that they're most likely going to win this first round series. The Clippers are most likely going to win this first round series now. Man. Now, however, though, people have been suggesting to trade Jimmy Butler from this. No. He is the culture setter. He had a culture before Jimmy Butler, but he's been a culture setter for this team and a team that gives him hard work and passion and shit like that. Why would you trade him? Now, I understand, don't give him that extension. That extension will be paying him $50 million while he's 36. And unless he ages like LeBron James, I mean, I don't even know if current Jimmy Butler is worth $50 million. I mean, maybe he is. But no, unless he ages like LeBron James or like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, there's no reason to give a 36-year-old $50 million. So you shouldn't give him that extension. But at the same time, you shouldn't trade him. Now, that's my thoughts on if the Miami Heat were a fluke or not. Thank y'all for watching the video, man. I want to give a big shout out to y'all. My video the other day on my draft predictions hit 1,000 views, which I came out of nowhere. But man, we growing the channel. If you a new part of the fam, shit, make sure to subscribe.